Ultimately, 3 points tonight, that was the most important thing.
Yeah, definitely. I thought real professional performance second half when you look at, you know, conceded no shots on target. I think, you know, the danger sometimes when you're one up and they're down to 10 and you go and chase it, and, you know, we didn't need to do that. You know, we had some decent chances, I thought, as well. You know, Theo had a good one at the back post, Twiney had another good chance, and I thought we showed a real level of professionalism second half in terms of controlling the game, managing the game and making sure that, you know, the biggest thing is that we finished with 3 points.
How did you enjoy the occasion playing against AFC Wimbledon?
Yeah, loved it, to be fair. I think, I have to say, I thought the fans really helped us get over the line tonight. I thought the atmosphere was incredible, and, you know, you look at it the second half of the season, that's going to be key. So, you know, if they can turn up every week and do what they did tonight, it was massive, and, you know, it's a huge appreciation for me. You know, the players, the staff, everybody, in terms of the atmosphere they generated tonight, because it definitely helped us see through the game.
Franco came in tonight, he didn't have a huge amount to do, in all honesty, this evening, but he looked assured, he looked calm, and he must have enjoyed it himself, getting a clean sheet.
Yeah, definitely. He's a terrific character, Franco. He's a real team player, and, you know, he stepped in, he did well tonight. He showed a good level of composure, his kicking was good, and, you know, huge credit goes to him and, you know, Lewis Price in terms of the work they do day in, day out, because he has got better, so yeah, he did well tonight.
And Theo slotted in, you know, obviously maybe ran out of legs a little bit towards the end of the game, but did create some chances and looked menacing at times.
Yeah, looked a threat, and I think you can see he brings a different dimension. He looks to take people on, and, you know, the one where he cuts inside in his right foot and flashes it past the post, you know, I think that when you look at it, we've got, you know, real attacking threat, and yeah, I was pleased with him tonight. He's only had one session with us, so it's also that case of, you know, getting him up to speed with things, tactically understanding, you know, how we play, what we do, but, you know, he should be pleased with how he did tonight.
I think we've already mentioned it, but, you know, even though your side were dominant in this game, there was still just that one goal, and I think there were a few nerves floating around in the final kind of 15-20 minutes of the match.
Yeah, and you get that. You know, you never, even against 10, as we found last weekend, you're never going to play the perfect game. There's always going to be moments where you are a little uncomfortable, and I think that's always the thing, you know, that such a big thing, perception. You're playing against 10, everyone thinks you should cruise it, and the game's never like that. You know, when you've got some committed professionals like they have, I think, you know, biggest thing, we showed a level of professionalism and control and normally maturity for me in terms of doing what we had to do to win the game and get the 3 points on the board.
You'll probably sleep well tonight. 3 points, winner over AFC Wimbledon. You stop a sequence of three games without a victory here, up to fifth in the playoffs. It's been a good night, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's been a decent night, but, you know, I think, like we've always said, we can't get carried away. We've still got a load of football to play this season. I think, you know, going into the game at the weekend's a really important one, that we prepare properly. The lads, you know, get the right rest, the right recovery, and, you know, and we go again. I think that's the biggest challenge in this league, and that was another pleasing element. Obviously, we were frustrated, disappointed, you know, away at the weekend. To then respond like we did tonight, you know, was really pleasing. So, you know, huge credit to the guys. I'm really pleased.
Great atmosphere in here tonight, wasn't it? Obviously, showed what it meant to the fans.
Yeah, I have to say it was terrific. I genuinely thought they helped us get over the line tonight. And, I think, as I said just previously, I think that's going to be massive for us the rest of the season. You know, if we can generate that atmosphere in this stadium, I think that, you know, it's massive for the guys. You do feel the buzz, you feel the energy. It does shift momentum in matches. So, you know, I thought the fans were terrific. It was a great experience.
Great battling performance, I thought, from Ethan Robson as well in the centre of the park there.
Yeah, he's had to bide his time and be patient. You know, as a few of the guys have, and he stepped in. He showed a level of aggression to break up play, and then, you know, showed some good moments in possession as well. And I think the biggest thing in games like that is discipline. You know, whether it's with the ball, whether it's your positioning, you know, he did a good job tonight. But like a lot of the guys, it's hard to single anyone out, because I thought that, you know, everybody showed a real collective spirit and a collective professionalism to get us through.
I suppose it's one of those where you might go home tonight and really consider just how big a win this is tomorrow, perhaps.
Yeah, I think it's a big win, but you still only get 3 points, right? I think that's the biggest thing. You know, I don't want to get too high, too carried away. It's obviously a massive win for the fans, for the club, but, you know, at the same point, we have to get ready now for Saturday. It's not about, you know, like I said, you don't get extra points, you know, for beating AFC, so we have to make sure that we do what we can to get ready for the weekend.
How's the hunt for a goalkeeper going?
Yeah, we're working hard.
Talk about the goal. Great effort from Issa to battle with the keeper, and then a really nice, well-worked team goal overall.
Yeah, Mo set the press really well, I thought, tonight. I actually thought we did it. We did it well, even with, you know, it was one of the things we said when they're down to 10, use the extra man. So I thought Mo did terrific for the goal in terms of, you know, and said it week in, week out. That comes from attitude. It comes from hard work. There's nothing... you know, fancy about it. But if you want to win matches and you want to, you know, do what we want to do this season, things like that are invaluable. So it was a terrific moment that doesn't go unnoticed in the changing room, that's for sure.
Mo's work rate today was exceptional. Just couldn't get a goal himself.
Yeah, of course, you know, and he wants to score goals, but, you know, like I say to the guys, and what we have here is our culture, is team first mentality, and he did exactly what the team needed tonight. He led the line, he played on the shoulder, he chased, he fought off long balls, he did what he had to do for the team, and that's really important. It's, you know, the goals will come from Mo. I've said it to him numerous times this season. It's keeping that level of, you know, defensive qualities, that desire to run and to compete. And look, he got into some dangerous areas, which, you know, he'll take goals. I'm sure of that.
Tanai Watson, who has previously played for AFC Wimbledon, really enjoyed tonight's game, it looked like.
Yeah, and he stepped in and did well too, I thought, to be fair. Obviously, you know, Peter played at the weekend. T came in, and it's good competition between them two. I thought T stepped in, he got forward well. He actually allowed Theo to drift wide by going inside, I thought he showed some moments of real quality. You know, he obviously nearly scored first half as well, with Harry Darling ending up blocking the shot. So he did some really good things tonight too.
The goal was one of several moments, particularly in the first half, where your team won the ball high up the pitch. Is it good to see them consistently able to do that?
Yeah, it's one we've spoken around. I think we've looked at that in terms of, I think we're a team, we're our best when we're on our front foot. You know, when we take it to the opposition, when we try and engage higher up, but, you know, from a disciplined structure, I think that's the key to it. I thought we did that really well again today. And it just allows us to obviously be closer. I thought we looked quite dangerous. I thought we counter-pressed really well. And then when we did do that, like I said, I thought we looked dangerous on the counter-attack. And, you know, and I think it's then a case of, you know, can you get that extra shot at the end of it?
We've seen some teams in the past get unsettled when they lose their first-choice keeper. I thought the defence overall tonight, though, seemed to do pretty well in the first game post the departure.
Yeah, I think it's a big thing for the group, I think, in terms of what they have got is a real closeness, a real togetherness, which we have to keep. With the COVID situation, with, you know, the change in, you know, head coach at the start of the year, they've had a few moments where they've had challenges. And what I know about the group and about the lads is that, you know, they focus on the things which are important, which is the controllables, and that's turning up tonight and doing what they did.
Heart and mouth moment when that shot from just outside the box and injury time went slightly past the post.
Yeah, there was a couple of moments at the end, but like I said, the game's never perfect. I think, you know, credit to the guys how they defended the set pieces at the end, and, you know, they showed a real fighting spirit, which is ultimately why you win the game.
How good is it for the development of Ronnie Sanford, the academy goalkeeper, on the bench today?
Yeah, it's a terrific experience for him. I think, you know, we like Ronnie. He's really progressed, you know, whilst he's been training with us, and, you know, I think, you know, experiences like tonight are only going to help him. The challenge is now to go, right, how does he get himself there, and, you know, turn up every day, you know, and the challenge is for him to drive Pricey and not the other way around. How does he really drive his program to, you know, become the best goalkeeper he can? So, you know, the club has a huge history of obviously bringing through academy players, and, you know, we had obviously Brooke on the bench as well. So, you know, you've got some guys around it that, you know, credit to the academy for what they've done.